Hello everybody, in this lecture we learn how to use nested functions in Python. Actually, nested functions are very important because if you want to learn concept of decorators, we need to learn before we need to learn nested functions. Okay, let's get started. And here in Python we can define functions inside another functions, and for such functions we call them nested functions. Let's create our first nested function, and after that we'll talk about it. Here I will say def, my definition, and I will name it for the first one main function. I will say parent, and after that here I will say print, printing from parent function. Okay, and after that I will create a child function, and I will name it child def child. Okay, and I don't pass any argument, and here I will say printing from child function. Okay, and now how can I call my child function and also parent function? This is important. Here I need to call my child function here. Okay, and now if I call my parent function, I will run this both print functions, and cancel, let's say, and here I will say parent. Okay, and now I will press shift and enter. As you see, Python returns to printing from parent function. Okay, that one, and for second print it said printing from child function. Our child function is a local function, okay, here, and it is only available inside parent function and can only be used within parent function. If we try to call it outside of parent function, we will get error. What I mean here, for example, if I copy this guys and paste it here, okay, and if I call my child function outside of my parent function, here is also outside, but I will paste it here, okay, and if I press shift and enter, as you see, it said name child is not defined because the child function only available in parent function. Okay, we cannot call it outside of our parent function. Okay, and what is next? Here our code is like that, right? And if we return our function, we will get same results, output actually, result. Or what I mean here, I will copy this guys and paste it here, and now if I say here return child, I will get same output. Let's try it. As you see, I got same output. Okay, Python returned before same thing like here, and this one is same. Okay, and now let's make another nested function. For that I will say outer. Okay, and here I will not pass any argument like here again, and after that I will say a is variable is equal to 10. Okay, and def another my child function, I will say, let's say alright and okay, and here I will say def, my function name is inner. Okay, and here I will create a static variable b is equal to 8. Okay, and after that here I will say return, sorry, here I must use colon, return a plus b. Okay, and now I need to return my function, okay, the inner function. How I will say, I will say return inner, and now I can call my main function outer, and if I press shift enter, let's how it will work. It should be my result 18, right? Because a plus b is 18. Okay, now shift enter, as you see Python returns me 18. Okay, but now I will make another example, and I will talk about why we are using here parentheses and here we use, but for this other function why we didn't use parentheses. Okay, here I will say def again, let's say outer. Okay, and now I will use here variables, okay, parameters, and the first one will be x, and after that here I will say def inner function. Okay, for the inner I will say y. Okay, and now I will say return x times y. Okay, now I also need to return, we need to understand something. We need to always return our child functions, okay? And not always, but yes, we need to return it, okay? Keep it like that. And but we can't return our main function here. So I have only one function right here. Not always, but you will understand because we have another also examples. Here, I need to return my inner function. And also, when we learn decorators, we need to return our child functions, okay? I need to return my function, but here I will say return only inner, okay? I will not use here parentheses. Why it's like that? Because in this example and here, we didn't use any parameters, right? Any arguments. But here we use parameters, but this argument is static. So we must use parentheses here. But here they are not static. So we need to use parentheses. We cannot use parentheses, okay? When we use parameters, we will not use parentheses when we return our function. But if our parameters static, or if we don't use, we need to use parentheses when we return our functions, okay? Simple like that. Now here I need to assign my first main function to another variable, and I will say f is equal to outer, and now I need to pass in argument, okay? And for the outer, for the x, I will say 5, okay? And after that, here I will say print. Now I will give pass in argument for f, and now I will say 4. It's like this one is 5x, and after that for y I used 4, okay? Now if I press shift and enter, as you see, it returns me 20, because 5 times 4 it is 20, okay? And let's also learn multiple nested functions, how they are working. Here I will say def first, okay? And for the first I will say x, for the second I will name it second, and I will say y, and the last one I will say third, my third function, okay? And my parameter is z, okay? And after that here I will say return. Let's make multiplication. So I will say x times y times z, okay? And here I need to return my functions, right? I have two functions here. First one is third, last one is third, and the other one is second. So firstly I need to return third. As you see here, I have parameters, okay, and they are not static, so I cannot use parentheses. And after that, here I will say return second, okay? And here now I can call my function. And how can I call a kind of functions? I will say first, and for the first argument I will say 2, and for the second one I will say 3, and for the z I will say 4, and it should be 2 times 3 6, and 6 times 4 is 24, right? Let's press shift enter. As you see, Python returned me 24, okay? And our last example, we can use another function as a argument and pass it into our main function, okay? What I mean here, I will say def main, okay? And I want to create an argument here, operator, okay? Op, and after that I will use args, okay? And now I will say def add function, and here I will use args, okay? And after that, what I can use sum function, but also we can use for loop. Anyway, I will say total is equal to 0, and now for loop for I in args. And after that I will say total plus equal I, right? And now what I need to do, I need to return my total variable, okay? And other one here I will say def multiplication, and I will say star args, okay? And the total here, of course, I need to create my total variable again, but this time it must be equal to 1, because if it is 0, it's equal to 0, that means my result will be 0. So I will say total is equal to 1, and after that I will say for I in args, okay, total star equal I, okay? And now what I need to say, I need to say return total. And like before, we returned our functions, right? But here, what I need to return? I need to return here my operator, okay? This is because, as you see here, this is the main function. And its child function is second. And the third is child function of second, okay? So, but this is different here. So how can I return my here operator? I need to return here my operator and arguments. How can I do that? I need to say here return, and we have a keyword for locals, okay? I will say locals, and for my operator, I will say op. And after that, for my arguments, I will say star args. Okay, and now if I call my function main, right, for my operator name here, I can say at, and also for the multiplication, right, this guy and this guy. Of course, we can add more functions, okay, here, but I have only two, okay, and I will say here, let's say at, for at, okay, string value and quotes, and here, let's say for arguments 8, 7, 9, -4, -4, -5, and -10. Okay, and now if I press Shift and Enter, let's see our result. As you see, and now for my addition, it is sum of my numbers. It is 16. And let's also use this one for second function. How can I do it? I will come here, and here I will say my main function main. For my operator, I will say mul, okay? And after that here, let's use range function, okay? How can I use it? I will say here star range. I can let's say 100. 100 is very big, actually. Let's say it doesn't matter. But I think it will be zero because it is zero. Why it's selected? Because as you remember, range function starts from zero and until given arguments, right? So what I need to do here, I need to say 1, 100, okay? Now if I press Shift and Enter, as you see, I have a really huge number here. And now I hope you understand how we can use nested functions, because after this lesson, we will learn decorators, and the nested functions is very, very important concept for decorators. For now, that's all. See you in the next.